greetings. I received an interesting denial from a Muslim. Well, the problem is, dude, we do not believe the Bible and the Torah are corrupted. There is no verse in the Quran that says that. Huh? I could not believe what I was reading, so I reread it. The problem is, dude, we do not believe the Bible and the Torah are corrupted. There is no verse in the Quran that says that. Shocking, right? Calling the Bible and Torah corrupted is Islam's Jihad 101 to defend against the Torah and Bible. It is the primary way Islam has conditioned Muslims to dodge the Torah and Bible refuting the Quran. In fact, in the Quran it threatens the believers with hellfire if they do not believe in Torah and Bible. Okay, at least this is common core for the Dawa of deception. A Muslim may claim they believe the Torah and Bible, the missing, original, uncorrupted Torah and Bible, even though there are no such things. The Torah and Bible we have are the real deal. Also, there is an hadith where Prophet Muhammad, and this is an appeal to the hadiths, which are as useful as a screen door on a submarine. If a hadith is useful, it is called authentic, and cited as if Muhammad had the authority of Allah. If a hadith is embarrassing, it is called inauthentic, even though it is right there next to an authentic one. Also, there is a hadith where Prophet Muhammad put his hand on a Torah and says that I believe in the Torah and it came from God. That almost sounds like a legitimate, acceptable position. I think Donald Colbert would welcome Muslims in America who would put their hand on a Bible and swear it was the Word of God. In fact, if a Muslim actually believed and respected this hadith, they would read the Torah and Bible. So I have to play along and see where this goes. I replied, "Great! If you believe that, then you believe the prophets that reveal Jesus is God, right?" Unfortunately, my friend, your claim contradicts the claim of every one of Muhammad's slaves on earth. They must make the claim of corruption because the Torah and Bible refute the Quran. The Torah and Bible prove that Jesus is the God of the Old Testament. So many make the claim they believe in the Torah and Bible, but then they all claim some imaginary Torah is not corrupted, and some imaginary Bible is not corrupted. The moment you show a Mohammedan black and white scripture and verse, they call it corrupted and ignore it. Do you want the truth, brother? The proof is in black and white. Just say you want to know the truth, and I'll gladly share it with you. And only a day passed. I am sorry to say this, but Jesus never said he was God or said worship me. Torah doesn't say Jesus is God. Judaism's view on Jesus is that they think he is a false messiah. Not only that, just like the Muslims, they believe that Jesus never claimed to be God. I'll tell you this simple truth. Muhammad, peace be upon, is the prophet that was promised in the Torah and will be like Moses. Jesus is the Messiah and a prophet like Moses and Muhammad. God is one and has no partners. The belief that the two books are corrupted are just false claims that came out of nowhere and sticked, just like the West believing that radicals are killing themselves for 72 virgins, which has not been mentioned in any hadith, just a false claim that sticks. And that was quite a mouthful of misinformation. I did not message back with a point-by-point refutation. Perhaps I should, quickly, here for clarity. I am sorry to say this, but Jesus never said he was God or said worship me. I responded, "Bless your heart, brother. There is a really childish teaching by the leaders of Islam that Jesus had to say, 'I am God, worship me,' in only 5 words for it to be true. The fact is, nowhere in the Quran does it say in 5 simple words, 'I am Allah, worship me.' I've challenged Muslims to produce surah and ayat showing the 5 simple words, and none have. They piece together different phrases from different contexts. Therefore, the childish argument condemns Islam as well. So perhaps you should consider a different jihad. A second issue I did not raise was saying the five simple words does not establish deity. Any fool or liar can say the words, I am Allah, worship me. I'll tell you the simple truth. Muhammad, peace be upon him, is the prophet that was promised in the Torah and will be like Moses. When I first heard the claim that Muhammad was foretold, I got excited. It sounded interesting. I thought, why haven't any pastors or teachers shown me this deep knowledge? And I decided to study and honestly examine every claim by Islam that Muhammad is somehow mentioned. Deuteronomy 18:18, Song of Solomon 5:16, Isaiah 29:12, John 14, John 15, John 16, and others. I have examined nearly all of them, and if you want the truth, brother, watch my playlist, Is Muhammad Mentioned in the Bible? I know the truth, and I know that I know, brother. My videos contain the truth. Watch them, and if you have any evidence, any verse, anything you wish to ask, let me know under the video. If you will not watch them, you do not want the truth, and that disrespects Almighty God. Jesus is the Messiah and a prophet like Moses and Muhammad. God is one and has no partners. This is a fascinatingly incoherent statement of Islam's position. Because Muhammad is like Moses, and Jesus is not like Moses. I kid you not, there are many grocery lists how Jesus is not like Moses. There was one other item I addressed separately. Torah doesn't say Jesus is God. Judaism's view on Jesus is that they think he is a false Messiah. Not only that, just like the Muslims, they believe that Jesus never claimed to be God. There is one other matter, brother, that you should really consider. You offer as evidence that Jesus is not God the Jewish statement that Jesus was a false Messiah. That is called a two-edged sword, brother, because while the Jews say Jesus is not the Messiah, and you offer the Jewish position as the truth and proof against Jesus, you also disprove Islam's claim that Jesus is the Messiah. The Jewish position also calls Islam wrong for believing Jesus is the Messiah. The arguments or excuses for Islam are never logically coherent, as this last point exemplifies. If you wish to offer the Jewish position as the fait accompli, you might also want to apply it against your own position and claim. God is one and has no partners. The belief that the two books are corrupted are just false claims that came out of nowhere and sticked, just like the West believing that radicals are killing themselves for 72 virgins, which has not been mentioned in any hadith. Just a false claim that sticks. Brother, I hope you actually mean that you respect the Torah and Bible, because they speak of Jesus, the Son of God. Jesus said that he shared God's glory with God before the world was created. John 17:5. Now, Father, glorify me together with yourself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was. But God revealed he would never share his glory with another God. Isaiah 42:8, I am the Lord, Yahweh, that is my name. I will not give my glory to, meaning share my glory with, another, nor my praise to graven images. And yet Jesus said he had shared God's glory with God. Both statements can only be true if Jesus is not another separate God. They are both true because Jesus is one with God. John 10:30, Jesus said, I and the Father are one. John 14:9, Jesus replied, Philip, I have been with you all this time and still you do not know me? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Matthew 11:27, all things have been entrusted to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and those to whom the Son chooses to reveal him. The belief that the two books are corrupted are just false claims that came out of nowhere and sticked. Actually, brother, the claim the Torah and Bible are corrupted came when Muslims began to read and understand the Torah and Bible. At that point, it was obvious, meaning impossible to ignore, that the Torah and Bible refute the Quran. Islam's only way to avoid the consequence of respecting the Torah and Bible was to call them corrupt. The consequence of respecting the Torah and Bible is one must reject the Quran as a false message. And sticked, just like the West believing that radicals are killing themselves for 72 virgins, which has not been mentioned in any hadith, just a false claim that sticks. Again, brother, you should honestly study the hadiths and Islamic sources. There is even a wiki web page devoted to this singular topic. Musnad Ahmed ibn Hanbal, Sunan al-Tirmidhi. Point number 5, he shall be coupled with 72 spouses from the wide-eyed maidens of paradise. Sunan al-Tirmidhi, volume 4, chapter 21, hadith 2687. The humblest of the people of paradise shall have 80,000 servants and 72 wives. Saifat al-Janna al-Ukayli of the Duafa. The servant in paradise shall be married with 70 wives. Ibn Majah, Ibn Abi Adi of the Kamil, and Il-Bakia, blah, blah, blah. None is made to enter paradise by Allah Most High, except Allah Most High shall marry him to 72 wives, 2 of them from the wide-eyed maidens of paradise, and 70 of them his inheritance from the people of hellfire. So these are hell-bound infidel pagans that get into paradise as the sexual slaves of a... that's interesting. These are only 4 of many references. Look them up yourself if you are interested in the religion you proselytize for. And I truly, sincerely am willing to teach you the message of the prophets that Islam denies. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.